Okay, I do apologize. I'm a little bit late today, 5 minutes, because of technical issues. But it seems like we are online now, which is awesome. I've got the chat open on my screen. I'm actually going to resize the windows. So if there is anything you want to ask me during the session, or if you know anything requires some explanation, etc., do let me know. I'm just going to rearrange my windows quickly and then we can start. Okay, so that's going to be helpful. Let me guys know who is on the line. I'm broadcasting today on YouTube and Facebook. So we'll see how it goes. It's the first time I'm doing that. So hopefully there are no technical issues. We'll see. Okay, good. So that seemed to be working now. Okay, good. So let's get started. Hi, everyone. Hopefully that's going to work. Good, I think we should be all right. Okay, so today's session, how to make money online. And I've got actually quite a lot of things to go through with you. And I really want to go through different business models, what's available today, what is the best thing for your personal circumstances, because there is like tons of various ways of making money online. And even if you are a beginner, even if you don't have any experience, etc., but you need to pick the right model for your own budget and your own circumstances. Okay, so first of all, let me just switch my screen, and I wanted to share with you a few announcements. And this is actually my script for today. So there is quite a lot of things to go through. I'm going to enlarge it in just a second, but I wanted to share with you a couple of things. Okay, so first of all, remember we do have the WealthX project, which is all about three key stages, which is the mindset, the skill, and the multiplying of your money once you build the initial stream of income. Okay, so have a read. I don't want to take too much time here, so have a read. I'll post the link in the description, in the comment section, and you can have a look at this later if you are not familiar with this or if you are not a part of that project. The second thing I wanted to actually announce is I have decided to write a book, which is going to be the Success in a Pill book. How to get rich and live the life on your own terms. I was encouraged, actually, I asked that question in the Facebook group, and I was encouraged by the multiplicity of the answers I received. And also, I asked this question to my database, and you know, the response was amazing. So I decided, what the heck, I'll do this. So that is being written now, and I'm working on that. Actually, I've got a full brief now, and it's going to be actually amazing. I don't want this to be a Bible, 350 pages, but rather a booklet or a handbook, like a concise step-by-step guide. And your blueprint to success. And I wanted it to be something that you can actually refer to anytime you want, anytime you feel like it, anytime like when you are feeling lost or tired or have a life crisis, something like that, there will be answers in this book. So if you want to pre-order this book, it's going to be only $9.79. As a pre-order, you can do this right now, and it's going to ship as a printed copy in January 22. And also, I'm going to create an ebook for it as well, so you can listen to my voice. So, I'm going to post this link in the chat as well. Hopefully, you are getting my messages. And if you want to follow this link and pre-order your copy, that's just going to make this book even better, because I'm going to have additional motivation to do this, okay? So that's that. And the third thing I wanted to share with you is the life plan. So basically, we are approaching the end of 2021, and you know, various people had various successes in this year, and I want to make sure that people have more and more successes and have actually a strategic plan in place for the 2022, because you don't really want to start working on that, you know, in February, March, or April. You want to really go into the 2022 with a strategic plan, knowing what you want to achieve, knowing how you are going to achieve, what you need to learn, what is going to be your mindset, what is going to be the skill you need to have, etc. What are the changes you are going to have to make in 2022 for this year to be the best year of your life. So that is the purpose of the Life Plan, a new service. It's just available right now, and I literally created this page today. So if you want to book this with me, you can post the link as well here. If you have any questions, ask me, but I don't want to take too much time right now. I will be sending emails about that, and I will be posting in the Facebook group. So if you stay tuned, you can, but if you want to be the one of the first few, then you can absolutely book your sessions now. Okay, so we've got all the links right now. Any questions, let me know. And other than that, I think we can get started. Okay, so I'm just going, I've got two screens, but I think I need to get another one as well. Anyway, okay, so I'm going to move this away, so hopefully we can see everything, and let's get started with actually making money online. So okay, I'm going to enlarge this. I do apologize about my handwriting. But anyway, this is more for me to know and not to miss any information I want to give you. Okay, so in this session, in this evening, I want to actually discuss the five best ways to make money from home. Okay, and those five ways will actually include three passive income ideas as well. And the first question we need to ask is, why do we want to do this? Okay, why do we want to find a way to make money from home and, you know, make money online and, you know, even build those passive incomes? And the answer is cash flow. Okay, you really want to build a cash flow for yourself, so that cash flow can pay for your lifestyle, for your expenses, for your mortgage, for your car, etc., etc. Okay, so the key word here is cash flow, and there is nothing stopping you from having a multiple streams of income. There is nothing stopping you from building one of the cash machines, getting it to the point where you want it to be, and then basically building another cash machine on top of it. Okay, so the sky is the limit here, but you need to have the skill, you need to learn how to do this, you need to get in the right mindset, and you need to learn the skill as well, which is what I want to kind of introduce to you to today. And people often ask, if you look online, people often ask how to make money online, you know, even as a teenager or as a kid, okay, and how to make money online with no money or no investment, and what is the easy way to make money online. And the first model I wanted to discuss with you is the affiliate marketing. And why is that? Well, simply because the affiliate marketing can be a passive income, okay? It can be a passive business model if you structure it right, okay? But first of all, you want to know what it is and how it works, okay? And I actually split this session into a few modules for each of the ways of making money online. So the first one obviously is what it is. The second one is going to be how it works. Then what kind of budgets we are looking for? We are looking at for this particular business model. Then how to make a decision if this is for you, what it takes, and how to deal with challenges here. Okay, so that's what I want to do. So let's start with the affiliate marketing. Hope you guys can see it. Yeah, I think so. So affiliate marketing, like I said, it can be a passive income, okay? Can be a passive income stream. So the thing you need to be aware of is you need really three things here. You need an offer, you need an audience, and you need a marketing. Okay, so let's talk about an offer. This is really, really simple. First of all, you can actually look at our affiliate marketing and you can become an affiliate of ours. I'll actually send you the link as well, which I don't think. Let me just grab this very quickly. Okay, so get code. So I'm going to post the link to our affiliate program if you want to take part in it, if you decide that the affiliate marketing is the right model for you. Okay, so first of all, you need an offer. So you can have an offer using our affiliate program, which is going to be our products, our services, etc. Or what you can also do is you can also use a service that is called a ClickBank. Okay, and ClickBank is pretty much a ser like a market. Think about this as a market where you can actually browse different offers, different I'm sorry, different vendors, etc., who have affiliate or referral program, and you can choose that offer, choose the one, the offer that actually suits you, and you can start promoting it. Okay, so this is the first thing. You need an offer, and you can either sign up for our affiliate program or you can pick any program that is out there. Okay, but there are a few things you need to keep in mind. First of all, you need to keep in mind the commission level, because if the commission is like 5%, you're not gonna be able to make money fast. Okay, you are thinking leverage, you are thinking cash flow here. So we need to look at the commission level. And ideally, I would say the commission level is anything between 20 and 40%. I would say even 30 to 40%. Okay, so in other words, if a product or service cost, let's say, £100, you would get a 30% commission for every sale, which comes as a result of your marketing efforts. Okay, super important to understand. Then the next factor is you really want a recurring income. Okay, so an income that comes, a commission that comes to you every single month. So, for example, some vendors will sell a product, you're gonna get a commission, and that's it. Okay, some programs, like for example, with our WealthX project program, you will get a recurring commission, meaning basically, for as long as that person stays a member, you will be getting a commission, 30%, for example. I don't remember exactly the rate we have right now on offer, but let's say it's 30%. Okay, and if a program costs £90 per month, that's £30 per month commission, or £40 per month commission for you for as long as that person stays a member. So that is brilliant, because think about that. Okay, if you get a few people per month, okay, to start with, you can start small and build on top of that, then that starts to stack up. And you know, 10 months down the line, you can be making very, very good money with that. And that is going to be pure passive income, okay? As I will show you in a second. So the first one is the commission level. The higher, the better. Generally speaking, 30 to 40% is very good commission. And then you ideally want to sign up for a referral program that has that recurring commission that is coming to you every single month. Okay, so you get an initial commission on the sale, and then you get the income, the commission, every single month. Okay, now then you need to consider the market for the offer. So let's say you select a referral program with a very niche market, and that market is really limited. You're not gonna be able to actually scale it a lot. So ideally, you want to pick a product within a market, that would be extensive, basically. So for example, with the WealthX project, we are talking about people who want something more from life. They want to achieve their goals. They want to move forward. They want to progress career, life, health, etc. So it's a quite a big market, okay? But there is a lot of products, a lot of referral programs like that, on the market as well. You just need to browse through them and find the one that suits you, which gets me to the fourth point, which is how you feel about this, okay? How you feel about that affiliate program. Is that something you are excited about? Is that something you would like to promote? Is that something you would like to sell to your friends, to your family, to your neighbors, to strangers? Okay, so those are the four factors you need to consider in terms of affiliate marketing: the commission level, the recurring revenue every month, the market, the size of the market, and how you feel about this, how you feel about the product. Is that exciting product for you? Because the more excited you are about the product, the more inclined you will be to actually promote this product. So that would be the first thing, the offer. Okay, then we've got the audience. So once you've got the offer, you need to find the audience for it. You need to think, who would be my audience for this particular offer or a product? So to start with, I always recommend start with people you know, start with your own circle, start with your own network. Because if you have an exciting offer, something you believe in, something you like, something you are excited about, then it will be easy for you. It will come through your posts, it will come through your message, it will come through when you actually talk to these people. So that would be my recommendation, okay? Then maybe start with people you vaguely know, okay? Maybe talk to some neighbors, okay? Hey, say, I'm in this business, I've got this product, I've got this offer, etc. Okay, and then move on to strangers, people you don't know, people online. And there is tons of things you can do, which I will give you some examples in just a second, okay? So that is the audience. So first you need the offer. Second, you need the audience, okay? And the offer is super easy to find, okay? Pretty much any offer you find, providing it meets the basic criteria as we discussed, will be all right to start with. And you can have 10 offers, you can have 15 offers, okay? Start with one, then grow, okay? If that's what you want to do, it can be a side hustle, it can be your main way of making money online. Then we've got the marketing, okay? That's the third kind of part of that system, okay? So once you've got the offer, once you know who your audience is going to be, then you need to do some marketing. And marketing, generally speaking, applies to strangers, people you don't know, people you want to basically reach out to, people who don't know you and you don't know them, basically. Okay, so start with people you know, start with your own circle, then start with people who you vaguely know, and then extend your network to strangers. Now, how do you reach strangers? Well, that's actually easier than you think, okay? So potentially you could do social media. That's probably the easiest way to do it, okay? So you could set up a Facebook page, for example. You could set up a Facebook group. you could set up an Instagram profile. You could set up a YouTube channel if you wanted to, or you could set up a blog if you like writing. And there is nothing stopping you from doing those things. It's super, super easy these days. And you are probably posting already stuff on your Facebook profile or Instagram, etc. So it's actually nothing new, okay? And you start posting or blogging or making videos about around that niche, around that product. So if I was selling something, some kind of, you know, referral offer for dogs, I don't know, a dog shampoo or something like that, I would probably start blogging or posting or making videos about dog pet care, okay? And how to care for your pets, you know, maybe even extend and think about how to differentiate yourself and, you know, extend your field of view. So maybe even post about, you know, training your dog or, you know, stuff like that. Anything that is connected with dogs, that would apply, that people would be interested to know about and learn more. And you can also use repost other people's content as well. There's nothing stopping you from doing that as well. So that is how I would do this. I would find the offer first. Either you can register for a program or find an offer on ClickBank. Then think about the audience, start with your own circle, then extend to strangers, and then do the marketing. So start actually getting these people. Invite your friends to the new Facebook page you set up, or to the new Facebook group, or for the new Instagram profile, etc. And you can build that into a really, really good business. So let's actually move to the next stage, which is the budget and earning potential. Now, the beauty about this model, that's why if you are a teenager or even if you are a kid, you can start that business model, because it doesn't really require money to start with. You can literally start with zero of your own money and build that into a 4 to 6 figure business. And you can do this often with one offer. Depending on your dedication and commitment, you can reach so many people, so many audiences online. It's a joke, okay? It's a super easy business model, and there is like tons of information on various techniques, etc., etc., okay? So again, you start simple with a Facebook page, with an Instagram profile, etc., and then you move, kind of expand from there. So you could, for example, set up a sales funnel, which I'm using extensively. So for example, those things I did show you before. So for example, that success book, that's a landing page, okay? If you click that button, it's going to take you through the checkout. And that is a sales funnel. It can be a simple two-step funnel, like for example this one, which is a landing page and a thank you page. Or it could be like, you know, 1,000 pages. I've got, you know, quite extensive funnels built as well. But start small, okay? And then later expand. Sales funnels, create a lead magnet. What is a lead magnet? Well, for example, an ebook, okay? You could create an ebook, how to care, 7 strategies to care for your dog, or 7 something or whatever, okay? And have that free for people to download, and then follow up with them, okay? You could then expand and create some ads, basically, and target people you don't know. Select the interests, select audiences on Facebook, and run some ads to your funnel or to the offer directly, etc. Okay, and then that is how you can scale, basically. So if that is what's interest you, you have 2 ways. There is an entire system in the WealthX project. So if that's something you are interested in and you register for the WealthX project, you will be able to learn that. But also, if you don't want to register for the WealthX project, there is tons of information online, on YouTube, in Google, etc. And there is nothing stopping you from getting that information. Now, The question you need to ask yourself is how to make a decision. Is affiliate marketing, is referral marketing the right business model for you? And the answer probably is yes, because that business model would be probably suitable for like everyone, I would say, whether it would be me, you, or someone else, whether you are a kid, teenager, whether you have no money or you have some money, etc., you have little time, you have more time, etc. That is a super flexible model, okay? And you can literally do this with zero of your money. You need to have some time, okay? Because if you decide to go the social media route, then you obviously need to do some postings, talk to people, etc., reply to messages. So I'd say maybe an hour, 2 hours to start with would be a good start, okay? You've got to have the commitment, okay? So we need to commit to it, because the earnings to start with, they are not going to be, oh my goodness, I can't believe I'm making so much money. It can happen, okay? But more often than not, you need to stack up the customers. You need to stack up the referrals so that recurring commission we talked about actually stacks up, okay? And you start, let's say, for example, you have, I don't know, 10 customers, you refer 10 customers in the first month, so that's £300, and that £300 rolls on over the next 10 or 15 months, okay, depending on the retention here. But then the next month you get another 10 customers, that's £600. Then the next month you've got that £600 a month, plus another 10 customers, that's £900 a month, and so on and so on. Do the math and see how it's going to work. 10 referrals per month is nothing. You can do so, so much better, okay? But what I'm trying to say is there will be some instant earnings, but you need to be a little bit of patient, okay? You need to be committed and you need to say, okay, I'm gonna give it a few months' time before I can reap the rewards, okay? And ideally you want to reinvest that money into your next business venture or grow that existing referral marketing venture, okay? So what does it take? Well, in terms of affiliate marketing, I think the biggest challenge people face is they feel salesy, like, you know, they are selling stuff and people don't really like to sell stuff, at least majority of people. And they feel like they are trying to sell something to their friends, etc. How to deal with it, okay? Well, first of all, you've got to have the confidence in the product. You need to know that that product is valuable, is life-changing, etc. If you believe in that product, you are going to be genuine. You are going to feel you are genuinely help people and you are adding value to their lives, okay? And, you know, there is nothing wrong with making some money along the process. Nothing wrong with it. I make some money when I sell something. When you go and work for somebody in your job or whatever, you know, you are adding value to your employer and they are paying you. Nothing wrong with it, okay? That's the whole world. So that's why I said you need to believe in the product. You need to have something that you are excited about and something you believe in. That is going to ensure you are not going to feel like you are trying to sell something push, okay? Think about that. If you had a cure for cancer, you wouldn't, you know, feel like, oh, I'm trying to sell something. You would go out and say, hey, I've got this cure, okay? I can help you guys and, you know, possibly make some money in the process, okay? So that's the first thing. You need to believe in the product and just don't feel like you are trying to sell something. The next thing is consistency. You've got to be consistent. If you are in it just, you know, from time to time and you are just saying, oh, okay, I'm going to do the post here and I'm going to do the post in 2 or 3 weeks, that's not going to work, okay? And yes, I need to confess, I am not consistent with my social media. I know that that's because I'm working on multiple projects. But I do intend to be more consistent, so stay tuned, trust me, it's going to happen, okay? So the best way to do this, if you are a one-man team, is to actually set time per day, okay? And that has to be non-negotiable. This is your time for your business, for your stream of income. That's non-negotiable. From 7 till 8 o'clock, I'm out in my office working on my laptop computer. I am consistent every single day. That's it, okay? That's how you deal with consistency. And people fail because they are not consistent with either the affiliate business model or some other models I will discuss today as well. And what it takes, the third thing is the time, okay? It takes time to build up the recurring revenue. So you will have some money the first month, but then, you know, it's going to take you 3, 4, 5, 6 months or 10 months to build that revenue. But once you have built that revenue, it's going to be passive, because even if you stopped doing that completely, that recurring revenue is going to come to you every single month. That's why I'm saying it's a passive income, simply because you don't have to do, once it's built, you don't have to do anything. Okay, so how to deal with it? Well, the sooner you start, the quicker you will get there. And you need to realize that now, okay? Because once you build it, it's going to be truly passive recurring income every single month, okay? So, like I said, the entire step-by-step system is in the WealthX Project on demand. If that's something you want, you can sign up for the WealthX Project and study it step-by-step, learn every single step, start small, and then grow. On that, if you don't want the WealthX Project, that's absolutely fine. Just do put in hours and learn how to do this. Okay, so let's discuss the next way to make money online, and that's going to be my area of expertise. My cash machine of choice, I would say, which is the Amazon FBA. Now, Amazon FBA is not as passive as people think, okay? And some gurus will tell you Amazon FBA is a passive business model, etc. Not really, okay? Unless you sign up for a new concierge program, which is where we do everything for you, that's going to be a passive. But if you do it yourself, you've got to be in business, okay? You can scale it with virtual assistants and have some work outsourced, but you still need to analyze the reports, analyze the products, and it's not a truly passive business model, passive income, if you know what I mean, okay? So what kind of how it works, okay? Let's discuss how it works first. Well, first of all, you've got to have a profitable product, okay? And that's the first step. You've got to have a profitable product. Then you need to find a supplier for this profitable product, and then you need to have a very good listing on Amazon. That's kind of the three stages we need to go through here. In terms of the profitable product, I always say that is super easy, guys, okay? People find it sometimes difficult, but it requires consistency. If you do it consistently, an hour a day, half an hour a day, etc., we've got a software that is called Zonebase, and you know, if you are interested in that, I'm more than happy to post a link for our students, WealthX Project students. We've got a 50% discount, because otherwise it works out quite expensive, but with a 50% discount, it's actually very cheap. And how to find the products, we actually have a full guide on that, a 5-day guide, 5 hours training on how to find those profitable products. It's a completely free training I have done in a Facebook group. Make sure to join that Facebook group. Did I post the link to the Facebook group? No, so I'll do this now. Facebook, if it allows me to. Yep, WealthX Project. So that's going to be our Facebook group. I'll post the link in the chat as well. So you have it. If you are not a part of this group, you need to join it, okay? If you are watching this on YouTube, join that group simply because there is like tons of free trainings. I'm doing all the free trainings in the group. There are guides, there are trainings how to find these profitable products. And also there is an extensive guide on that in the WealthX project as well. So then once you find that product using the software, which is that easy, you need to find a supplier. And finding a supplier, it takes a little bit of time, but it's easy because it's just a conversation, a matter of going to Alibaba, opening up the conversation, knowing what you want, knowing the set you want, and talking to these suppliers, okay? Hey, I wanted to order this product and I wanted to bundle it with this product. And what kind of quote and, you know, shipping can you can offer me, okay? And then that opens up a conversation. They will ask you questions. You will ask questions. You will make sure you understand the product, etc. Understand the quote. And once you are happy with the quote, once you are happy with the specification and the product and the supplier, you can place an order with them. And that product, that shipment will go straight to Amazon Warehouse. So that is a beauty of this model, because you don't have to store that product in your garage, you don't have to build a website, you don't have to build sales funnels. You can, as an advanced technique, and we do this, but that comes later. To start with, you don't have to do this, okay? So the third thing is you need to have the listing. So you need to set up a company. You can be a sole trader or you can trade as a limited company. You need to open up an Amazon account and your bank account if you are trading as a limited company. And then you need to create a listing for your product. So in other words, you need to create the title, the bullet points, you need to optimize it, you need to enrich it with keywords. You need to rank to the first page, because majority of sales happens on the first page of Amazon. And so you need to rank to the first page. How do you do this? With ads, with sponsored ads on Amazon. You optimize that, etc. And you don't even have to learn how to do this, because there is a service we use. You can outsource it. And again, for our students, we've got discounts for that. But you can outsource it and you can have people do it for you. Don't have to even be bothered with that, okay? But you still need to be in the business. You need to analyze the reports. You cannot just say, oh, okay, they will do this for me and just forget about this. No, it's not going to end up well. So that's why I say it's not a fully passive income unless you are on the Amazon Concierge, the new Amazon Concierge program. So budgets, what kind of budgets we are talking about and what kind of potential we are talking about. So first of all, I would say if you have about £1,500 or $1,500, that would probably be a good start. You can go as high as 5,000. I wouldn't probably recommend going higher, but that would be a good starting point for the stock plus shipping. And you can then scale it with virtual assistant in virtual assistants. In other words, you can find freelancers who will, for example, do parts of that business for you. For example, they will start looking for new products for you, or they will actually talk to suppliers in your name, etc. And there is really no limit to what you can have in terms of amount of products. You're gonna have 10 products, you can have one product, you can have infinite amount of products in your Amazon store. So Amazon is very, very good for scaling, and you can keep adding those products to your portfolio. I like to keep it around 10 very good products that I'm happy with it. I analyze them on a consistent basis, and if one of them is not performing as good as I wanted, I just get rid of it, I sell out, I don't reorder it, and I replace it with a new product. That's it, okay? And you can make, you know, 10, 15, 20,000 pounds sometimes with one product. So there is a lot of possibilities here. The entire system is in WealthX project, and there is a lot of information online on Amazon FBA as well. There is a lot of gurus, a lot of coaches as well. So you need to pick the right coach who you kind of resonate with, and you like the style of teaching, I normally recommend finding somebody who teaches it step by step in chunkable small steps, because otherwise it's very, very easy to get lost. And what you need to be aware, if you go the DIY route, you need to be aware of the outdated information out there. So keep that in mind, okay? Because there is a lot of outdated information there. So that is it. The potential, 5 to 7 figures, is very achievable with Amazon, and you can build it actually quite quickly, even sometimes within a year. The key here is the right mindset, which I teach in the WealthX project as well. So one product can generate anything between 500 to 5,000 pounds profit. If you have 10 such products, then you have anything between 5,000 and 50,000 pounds profit per month. Not too shabby, I would say. So yeah, so I'd say if you really like the Amazon FBA business model, but you don't have money right now, maybe start with the affiliate program, affiliate marketing, and then reinvest. Okay, so what does it take? How to make the decision, and is this for you? Well, first of all, you have to have some money. Okay, you cannot start Amazon FBA with zero money. Although you can start Amazon FBA with zero of your own money, because you can borrow money from friends, credit cards, personal loans. Right now the interest rates are like nothing, okay? So probably your friends or people who know will be glad actually if you can take the money from them, do all the legwork, and return say 10% to them in a year or so. Okay, so try that. It doesn't take money to build money. It takes courage, it takes determination, and it takes commitment. Okay, so it will require a little bit more time to do this, 2 or 3 hours per day consistently, and you need to be willing to learn, because the affiliate business model is easier. With Amazon FBA, you really want to learn every single detail of it, so you don't make newbie mistakes. Okay, so like I said, WealthX project or YouTube is your best friend, or any other courses as well, but just make sure you pick the right course for you and the right coach. You need to be computer literate, meaning you need to kind of know your way around folders, know your way around spreadsheets, etc., because you will be comparing information, you will be entering data about your products, about your research, about profitability, etc. So ideally you want to know your way around the files, folders, spreadsheets, Word documents, etc. You don't have to be a computer guru, but you need to have some skill and knowledge, okay? Mindset. That is the key, okay? Because where people fail with Amazon FBA business model or a way to make money online is the mindset, okay? They don't have the right entrepreneurial mindset. They say, oh, I'm going to learn a skill, I'm going to make shit tons of money, okay? That's not going to happen. I used to be like that. I used to be like that, and I used to teach the skill only, and then I realized, hey, something is not working here, okay? Because a lot of my students didn't achieve the same level of success as I did, and I started thinking about this, and then that is when it actually occurred to me that the skill is not enough. You need the right mindset, and that was the beginning of the WealthX project, because the WealthX project is about the mindset, the skill, and the growth, the three key stages of your life. And that is the complete picture, and that changes everything. Without the right mindset, even the simple things like the most successful sellers do not think they will make a lot of money with the first product, okay? They test it. They see if it's working or if it's not working. If it's not working, they discard the product, they sell it out, they move on to the next product, okay? That's the mindset. That's the kind of mindset the successful sellers have. The unsuccessful sellers, on the other hand, they jump in, they think with the first product they are going to do a lot of money. Yes, that happens, but not in all cases. Okay, so you need to have that mindset, and you need to be willing to wait about 4 months, I would say, is a reasonable, realistic time frame to launch your first product. With the second and third product, it's going to be probably quicker, but for your first product, you need to keep that in mind. Okay, and this is great because you can minimize contact with people. If you don't like talking to people, if you don't like dealing with people, like I was at the beginning, then that is an awesome business to be in, because you pretty much don't have to talk to anyone. Okay, you can do everything your own, and Amazon deals with customer service, so you don't have to. So that's brilliant. Now, what does it take? Well, it takes some money. Okay, and in terms of money, you can again get the money from people you know, personal loans, credit cards, although be aware of the interest rates there. Money is cheap these days, so you can get this money and start that business if you don't have the money on your own. Consistency is the second thing, and the way to deal with it is to have a set time per day which is non-negotiable, and you use this time for product discovery, which becomes your habit. You talk to suppliers, you do the discovery on a consistent basis. So you always have the surplus of products if one is not working, or if the supplier fails to provide you with an acceptable quote, then you move on to the next product. You don't end up in a position where, oh my goodness, I don't have a product, I don't have a supplier, and I don't have money. So you don't want to be in that position. That's where people fail a lot. Okay, so that again is a mindset. Skill, you need to have the skill here. Okay, and again, YouTube, WealthX Project, other paid courses. I've made the WealthX Project, I mean, guys, so easy and so affordable these days. So you can do this, or you can do this on your own, but you've got to learn. Okay, without learning how Amazon FBA works, I probably wouldn't do this. Okay, if I were you. Attention to detail. You need to have attention to detail. Okay, that's what it takes with Amazon FBA business model. Because you need to do the research, you need to kind of put all the specifications for the products, you need to pay attention to what suppliers say to you, understand the product, understand the features. Even if you don't know anything about that product, you can learn by analyzing the listings of your competitors, every single detail. Okay, I do this all the time with brand new products that I don't know anything about, for our students, for myself. And I always go in, I learn everything about those products, I analyze all the competitors, and I become kind of, you know, pretty much very fluent in, you can ask me anything about the product and I will know. Even suppliers don't know and I know. Okay, that's the level in detail you need to pay attention to. Okay, and the mindset, especially if your first product not working. Okay, this is to be expected. Okay, so you become a master, you expect things to happen, you say, ah, okay, this is to be expected, Michael said it's not going to work out the first time. Hope for the best, but be prepared for the worst. Okay, that's what I'm saying. So if your product, first product is not working, just sell it out, move on to the next product. There is like hundreds, thousands of products. Sell it out, get your money back, invest it in the next product. Don't give up once you embark on the Amazon FBA journey. Okay, so you need to realize this is part of the deal with Amazon FBA. That is it. Okay, the step-by-step videos, full system in detail. I mean, I don't think there is any other course on Amazon FBA that is so detailed, is in the WealthX Project again, or you can do this yourself online. Now, let's move to the third way of making money online. Now that's going to surprise you probably, but it's perfectly achievable. So I'm saying about opening your own digital marketing agency. Okay, great business model, guys. Great business model, because the way it works, this is definitely not a passive income. Why is it not passive? Well, because you have to talk to people. Okay, the way it works is you find an audience, you build a sales funnel, people arrange calls with you, and you do these calls, which we call strategic calls or strategy calls. You talk to these people, you present your offer, you listen to them, you present solutions, and you follow up with them. Okay, you follow up with them by email, by calls, etc. So let's discuss this. First things first, the audience. So how do you go about finding the audience? That would be probably business to business. So you would be finding let's start with what is digital marketing agency first, because maybe not everyone knows. So digital marketing agency is a digital marketing, is an agency that provides digital marketing services. Now, what are digital marketing services? It could be as simple as Facebook ads or Google ads. It could be as simple as social marketing, meaning Facebook posts, Instagram posts, YouTube videos, other social media channels, okay? So marketing is probably the most neglected part of the business, in any business, unless we are talking about those big businesses. But if we are talking about small businesses, the marketing is needed everywhere. That's why it's so great, okay? And yes, I know what you are thinking. You are thinking, I could never do this because I don't know anything about the ads or anything about the social marketing. And I'll show you the way to do this very easily, even without you knowing how to do this. But let's discuss what it takes, okay? How does it work, first of all? So you need to first find the audience, which means businesses that might need your help, might need your services. The best way to do this is Facebook ads, local newspapers, and have your eyes opened. Okay, so you go for a walk and you see a van with advertising on it. You know the phone number, you know the email, you look it up online, you contact that person. Local newspapers, businesses spend money on advertising. Find out how much they are spending. You know, if they have half a page, that's going to cost them money. How much they are spending. If they are advertising every single month, they are spending considerable amount of money. How about you offer them to do Facebook ads for them, and they will be able to reach more people and save money. Hey, that's a good deal, okay? So that's how you find the audience. Now, next. If you have an audience, what do you do? Well, you direct that audience into your sales funnels. Okay, the sales funnel can be as simple as landing page where you present your lead magnet, for example, a marketing strategy ebook, 7 ways to market your business or something like that. That's going to be free. They are going to download it, they are going to read it, and on the next page they are going to be presented with your booking calendar. Okay, that's a fully automated process. Booking calendar, where they can book a strategy call with you on Zoom, for example, or on Google Hangouts or whatever, Skype, however you want to do this, okay? And then you send them some initial emails to kind of prep them for that strategy call. And then there is the time when the call comes, okay? So you need to have the script ready, what you are going to say to them, how are you going to present the offer, what questions are you going to have. Remember, the call is about adding value. It's not about selling. It's about adding value, getting to know them, finding out what they need and if you can help them, okay? And then at the end you can present your offer that solves their issues, their problems, okay? You can outsource this, guys, okay? You can outsource the sales funnel. building, you can outsource the calls even if you wanted to. You can outsource the preparation of the script, etc. Okay, and you can outsource the follow-up as well, or you can have some team member doing that for you, sending emails, calls. That can be automated as well. Okay, remember, it's all about value and helping them to grow their business. Now, how do you go about this? Because remember, I will tell this in a second. So let's talk about how to make the decision. Is this going to be for you? Well, first of all, the budget. Let's discuss the budget first. So in terms of the budget, you probably need to have at least 500 to 1500 pounds for that, plus time, because it's going to take some more time to do this. And you can actually charge about 1,000 to 5,000 pounds net profit per client. That's after costs. Okay, so imagine charging 2,500 pounds per client, and you have, let's say, 10 clients like that. 25k profit per month, not bad. Okay, not bad at all. It's that easy to do, even if you don't know how to do this. So that's the potential. The potential is massive. It's going to require a little bit more time and work, but the potential is massive, and it's not going to be a passive business, because you have to do these calls and you have to be in that business, in my opinion. Okay, so is this for you? Well, you have to have some money, okay, or you can borrow money. You need to enjoy technical stuff. If you are not a technical person and you don't really enjoy social media, etc., it's probably not going to be for you. The next thing is, you need to be willing to learn, okay? So at least basic things about Facebook ads, for example, social advertising, social media marketing, etc. And you need to be willing to talk to people, okay? And sell to them. Don't be afraid of selling. If you have a great offer, if you have an offer that helps them, then hey, go for it, okay? That model can be instant earnings for you. It can be, simply because, you know, you set up the framework, you talk to the first client, you make a sale, boom, okay, you have 1,000 to 5,000 pounds per month. So you can actually very quickly build up that profit to pay for your lifestyle as well. And remember, that's going to be a recurring revenue, because you will be charging every month for that, okay, for doing those services. Now, what does it take? It takes just the basic skill, okay? It takes basic skill. You don't have to know how to do this. And now I'm going to give you a secret. You can actually have, you can outsource all these services. For example, what's that page? I'm using DashClicks for my digital marketing services. Okay, DashClicks. Have a look at that, but they can do pretty much Facebook ads, they can do SEO, they can do website design, they can build funnels, they can do social media posting, content marketing, Google ads, directory listing, anything that is connected with social media marketing, the basic stuff they can do for you. Okay, so what you would do is, you would set up the platform, okay, which you can outsource to somebody. You would do the calls with your customers, but once you sign up a client, you would actually outsource all the social media marketing work to DashClicks. Okay, you can set up your free account here, you pay them for doing that work, you charge more for that work to your customers, and you retain that difference, that profit. That's how easy that is. Okay, it's super easy, guys, and you don't have to have the technical specialist knowledge, because you can outsource every single service. So you basically build up the packages. Oh, I want to offer this, this, and this service within that package, and then you talk to people. You present your offer as a solution to their issues in the business, And then you outsource that work to, for example, DashClicks. Okay, so you need to do some preparation, you need to do the platform setup because you need to have the sales funnel for this to work, and you can outsource it. You need to prepare the scripts, you need to prepare your offer based on what DashClicks, for example, would charge you, and look up other. They are called white label digital marketing agencies or something like that. Look it up because they specialize in various things. You can use DashClicks for some of the services. You can use other services for some other services. Okay, and you need to do some prep, meaning you need to have the scripts, you need to have the offer, and you need to have some lead magnets to attract these people via advertising. Remember, advertising works best, which by the way can be set up and outsourced by somebody as well. You can find freelancers or people per hour, upwork.com, etc. Okay, but you need to get rid of the fear of talking to people. If you have a fear of talking to people like me, it's going to be difficult for you. Okay, if you have a fear of selling, you need to realize again that you are actually helping them. You are helping those businesses because they don't have time. They are working in business, they are serving their clients, and they do not have time for marketing, okay? Rarely they do all the social posting, etc. They need help. So you need to realize that, okay? So the basic skill, how to deal with those challenges. The basic skill, you just learn, okay? I'm going to include the full module, step-by-step guide on digital marketing agency in the WealthX project as well. So if you want that, let me know. That's going to be step-by-step. In terms of money, again, credit cards, you can take a loan, you can borrow the money from, you know, people you know, and just tell them you're gonna return 10% or something. They will kiss your hand probably for that. Platform, again, you can register with ClickFunnels. I use both ClickFunnels or Kartra. I use Kartra extensively and ClickFunnels for my digital marketing agency. You can sketch the funnel and you can outsource doing the funnel to somebody else as well. Or I'll give you the funnels, the ready-made funnels in the WealthX project if you want to. Then the next one, okay, the preparation, the scripts, the offer, and the lead magnets. Again, I would outsource it. I would sketch the basic brief for it, maybe do some sketch, maybe do some bullet points, etc., and just use people per hour, Upwork. There is tons of freelancers in there to do that work for you. Don't kill yourself, do as easy as possible, okay? You have the budget. That is what the budget is for, okay? Do you guys have any questions in the meantime? Let me know. Okay, let's move on. Fear of talking to people, okay? You need to realize you are helping them by, and also by doing it often, okay? If the more you do this, the fear will disappear, I'm telling you, okay? I had the fear of camera. I don't mind talking to you right now, okay? Now, yes, there is going, if you want this in the WealthX project, there is going to be an early release if there is an enough interest in doing that. It's a super thing in terms of the instant high revenue if you do it right, okay? Which is not possible with the affiliate marketing or Amazon FBA business model. So if the instant earnings are what you want, then that would be probably the right model for you. Okay, next one. Would you like to write a book like I'm doing now? Okay, so remember at the beginning I told you about that Success in Appeal book, which by the way, I hope you have pre-ordered. If not, do it now. But it is super simple, okay? It is, guys, super simple. You need to obviously have an idea, okay? You need to have an idea, and the book can be a passive income, because once you write a book, once you set up your sales funnels and your ads, it's passive. Okay, it's completely passive because you don't have to do anything. Okay, the book is there. It can even be in the downloadable format, or you can have someone doing the reordering process, okay, and posting like a virtual assistant or so. There are services to do this as well. So it can be passive income. And how would you go about this? Well, first of all, you need to write the book. Second, you need to set up. You need to set up for selling that book. And the third one is you need the audience. So let's discuss those things. First of all, write the book. How do you go about writing the book? Well, there are a few things. You can do this yourself, okay? But you need an idea for the book, something of value to people, something people would pay for. And it doesn't, if you don't have that knowledge, but there is something you really, really, really want to write about, then you can do research, okay? You can Google the information and rewrite that content, okay? For my book, that's going to be original based on my experience, based on what I teach, how I teach, etc. So it's a completely different, but if you want it, you could find an idea, say, I want to write a book on making money. Great, okay? Do your research. The more research you do, the more information you will have, the more materials you will have. Gather all the ideas, put it in the book, write the book, okay? The next option is to have a ghost writer, meaning a freelancer who will write that book for you. There is tons of people who will do this cheaply for you, and you will just get the book, okay? You review the book, you work with the ghostwriter until you are happy with the content, and then it's ready for printing. You give it to the graphic designer, they put it in design, they prepare it for printing, you print the book, that's it, okay? You self-publish the book, okay? You self-publish. You don't publish the book through a publisher because they will take all your money. You self-publish the book. So simply, you find a print service, okay? You send the design PDF file to them, a digital format, and they will print, they will make your book a reality. And you can also include, like I do, I'm going to include a printed copy, and I'm going to do an audiobook. So for the audiobook, you simply read the book, you record the audio version of your book. Okay, and you could have the print version, you could have the digital version of your book, and you could have an audiobook. Okay, and you could do a bundle of those and sell it as a bundle for whatever you want, depending on the book. Okay, I wanted to do $9.79, more like a promotion as a guide, rather than, you know, just making tons of money. But you can. If you write a good book, you can. Okay, then the next step is the setup. So the setup, you need a funnel. You need a simple funnel, okay? So for example, on my page, we have the landing page. Then we've got a checkout page, okay? And then we've got a thank you page. So it's a super simple sales funnel. Two pages really in the checkout, and you can have somebody to set it up for you, or you can learn how to set it up yourself. It's actually super easy, okay? And you could have some upsells. For example, if we talk about the next thing on our list, you could have that as an upsell. And you know, you sell a book, and then on the second page you do the upsell, you sell something of higher value to people, okay? And that's how you build that revenue as well. You could have some endorsements, so contact some people you want, ask them for a review for this book, which is what I'm going to do as well for my book. And you could market your book with some lead magnets, so you could have a short report as a teaser for the book when you advertise it, and then, you know, people download your teaser report for free. And then there is the link to buy the book, or you could sell the book directly, whatever works for you. depending on the price, etc. Okay, and then the third thing is you need an audience. Okay, so how do you get an audience? That simple. Social media, guys. Okay, social media, Facebook page, Facebook group, Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, whatever. Okay, you could also run paid ads. And you can outsource it as well. You can have somebody doing your social media like I have from tomorrow. And you can have somebody to set up your ads as well, okay? And you know, you could sell that to people you know, to your own circle first, because you know, if they are not willing to pay for it, then probably you need to start working on your message here, okay? So again, you don't have to sell the book once it's there. You can pre-sell it like I do. Okay, so I am in the process of writing the book. I'm not hiding this. It's a pre-order at a promotional price. Once the book is written, printed, that price will go up. Okay, that's how you pre-sell the book. And that also proves the concept, because if nobody buys that book right now at the pre-sale stage, what's the point of writing it? I'm writing that book, my book, for other reasons. So it's kind of to complement my range of services, what I do and what I teach, and also as a business card. So I've got my other reasons for doing that, but if you just want to make money with a book or with a range of books as well, then you ideally want to prove the concept. Run some ads, sell it to people who know, see if they will pay for it, prove the concept. Okay, that's it. So that is the process in terms of doing the book. It's that easy, and you can actually outsource majority of this. Now, the budget. Okay, what it takes in terms of money to actually sell a book. Well, I think you need about £1,000, to be honest, because you need some money to set it up, you need some money to print the initial batch of books, and you need some money to pay freelancers to set everything up for you if you don't have knowledge how to do this yourself. So if you know how to do this, if you have the technical knowledge like I do, for example, then maybe, you know, £300-£500. If you don't, then probably a little bit more, like £1,000 or so. In terms of earning potential, it's going to vary depending on the book, how well you advertise, how committed you are to it, etc. The potential is from very little to very a lot. I know it's not correct, but you can make a lot of money if it picks up, and you know, people love it and it's actually really good content, which I hope my book will be. So guys, if you already bought my book, then read it, give me the review, give me comments, because I need to know, okay? As soon as it arrives in your post box, read it, give me the comments, okay? But it has a potential to do little to a lot, depending on the price, depending on how you market, etc. So the next one is how to make a decision if this is for you, okay? Well, there are a few things you need to consider. First of all, what it takes. Okay, we need to discuss what it takes. So first of all, you need to do research. Okay, you have to have something to share, or you need to do extensive research on what people want and how to go about doing that. Okay, so if there is something you want to share, there is nothing stopping you from making this a reality. Okay, that's a great way of making money online. You need to enjoy social media, and you need to enjoy engaging with people on social media as well. So what I'm saying is, people will be sending you direct messages. You need to comment, you need to talk to influencers, you need to talk to other people on social media, etc. So that's a commitment, that's time, okay? A little money, I would say, £1,000 or £500 is not a lot to start an online business. So very little money, But you need to be willing to wait and be patient, okay? It can be instant earnings, because as soon as you set up, as soon as you start selling the book, you are making money, you are refinancing the book, you are financing everything. But you need, you know, in order to build up that revenue, you need to be willing, you need to be patient, because that book probably is not going to cost 70, 80 or £300, okay? It's more like maybe 17, maybe 20-ish, depending on the book, depending on the information, depending on the amount of content in it and the value it provides, okay? Remember, the bigger problem you solve, the more you can charge for it. And it can be a passive income. So if you want a passive income that doesn't take a lot of money to build, but you are willing to wait for it, and you enjoy social media, you enjoy chatting to people, etc., then that could be a business model for you. That could be a way of making money online for you. Okay, now, what does it take and how to overcome the challenges? Well, first of all, you need to have the existing knowledge. If you don't have the existing knowledge about the subject you want to write about, then you need to learn, you need to do your research, okay? Then again, you need to have some money, although you can use your savings, you can use credit cards, you can take a loan, and you can borrow from people to know, hey, I'm doing this idea, I think it's going to work out, it's brilliant, I'm going to help tons of people, lend me £500 and I'll return, you know, 10, 15, 20% in 5 months time or whatever, okay? Remember, the interest rates on accounts, savings, even stock market is crazy, okay? It's crazy. People will want to do this. Then you need to be willing to set up, okay, and to write the content. So that's going to be a challenge. If you don't like writing, if you don't have time to do this, and if you don't know how to set up, your way to overcome this is to actually outsource it, okay? There is like tons of freelancers, Upwork, people per hour, etc., okay? You need to have patience, because it's not going to happen overnight. So just realize this in advance and say, okay, it's going to take some time. Do this and you're gonna be fine. And then you need to build the audience, okay? So you need to be consistent. So you need to set a time per day, be consistent. That time is non-negotiable, like other ways of making money online. And you need to do this consistently every day until you get there, okay? And the last one is going to be actually an online course. And because I'm doing online courses, I think I've done quite a lot right now. Online course is not a passive income, okay? It's not a passive income. It's not a passive income stream. And it is a very good way of making money online, but it's not passive. And the reason being is it's going to take you time to build the audience, to engage with audience, to do the free trainings like I do, to update the course, to keep it updated, to record, to change, to stay on top of the things. So it's not like you build a course and you leave it to just run for like years to come. Okay, it's not a passive way, I can tell you that. So what is involved in doing the course? Well, first of all, there has to be something of value, something that people want, something that people are willing to pay for. And it needs to be presented in the form of course, webinar, and, you know, maybe in the Facebook group, like I do these trainings, okay? Then the next thing is the setup. So again, you need to have a landing page for your course. Then maybe you want to have some upsells. Then maybe you need to have a membership area, because you need to deliver that content, those lessons, video lessons, okay, for people to actually watch and follow your formula. And also you need to do follow-ups with people who didn't buy from you as a result of watching your webinar, watching your training, or seeing your advertising. You need to follow up with them. It can be set to autopilot, but it has to be set up. Okay, and the third ingredient is the audience. Obviously, once you have the value in your course, once you set it up, you need to sell it to someone. So you need to have an audience. And the best way to find the audience is to actually use social media channels, is to use paid Facebook ads, for example, and also collaborate with influencers. That's pretty much a free or very cheap way of doing, of promoting your value, your course as well. So that is really it, the value, the setup, and the audience, okay? Now, budget. If you don't have 3 to 5K to start with, it's probably not going to be for you, I'd say, because it's going to require some investment, considerable investment, into getting the initial audience to actually buy your courses. Or instead of money, you will have to invest time. So it's either time or money, okay? The potential is quite large here, 5 to 7 figures you can do. But again, you need to have some patience to build to it. Ideally, you would like to have some membership options so you can build that recurring revenue as well. Okay. So, what are we talking? Is this right for you? Let's talk about this. Well, you need to be willing to work hard. Okay. There is no question about this. Creating an online course takes time and is quite a hard and lengthy process, okay? That is not to put you off, simply because it's rather to make you aware of it, and also there is a great earning potential, remember, okay? You need to have some knowledge, so something valuable, something you want to share with people, something based on your experience. And it could be anything, okay? It could be maybe in terms of relationship, maybe your relationship works, okay? Maybe a relationship with your dog works, okay? Something that you could refer to based on your experience and share with people the exact formula, the exact strategy to get from where they are right now to where you are right now, okay? Based on your experience, your formula, by following your steps. Okay, so you need to have that. You need to have the money, obviously. One more thing. Online courses are absolutely amazing in terms of growth. Okay, if you have a strong need for growth and strong need for sharing with people, for contribution, for sharing, for connection, that is going to be the business model for you. Okay, that's going to be great because it will make you grow, I can guarantee that, and you will have tons of fulfillment from sharing your ideas, from connecting with people, and anything that is related to it. Okay, but you need to be willing to be on camera, on webinars, on free trainings, on your paid trainings, etc. And you need to be willing to invest time. It does take a lot of time, guys, okay? To create a course, it takes a lot of time. To do these free trainings, it takes a lot of time. And you need to be simply aware of it. If you are fine with that, if you like to share, if you like talking on camera, talking to people, then it's great, awesome, that's going to be for you. You need to be enjoying the building a team, okay? Because at some point, if you want to grow, you need to focus on creating the content and the trainings and let your team work behind the scenes on your sales funnels, on your advertising, on your social media, etc. Growth is the massive, massive benefit, okay, here. So what does it take? Let's start to wrap up this training. What does it take? Well, first of all, the knowledge, okay? So you need to have that knowledge. Use your existing knowledge, or if you don't have the knowledge yet, again, like with the book, study the subject extensively. Anything out there, you can learn. You just need to be willing to put in the hours to learn this, test the ideas yourself, and then turn it into a formula, into a blueprint, into a course. Okay, what it takes: being on camera. Okay, you need to be on camera pretty much constantly, and how to deal with it? Actually, very simple. You just do it, okay? Because you will get there. And the best way, when I was starting, I actually had quite a lot of scripts, like pretty much word by word, slide scripts, etc. And I was reading, okay? I was referring to those scripts, I was reading, etc. Now I can confidently speak on camera without pretty much referring to my notes. I am doing that because I want to give you every bit of information, and I can, you know, easily get lost in all this information, but I could talk about any of these business models without the notes, not a problem. So the more you do this, the better you will become, and trust me, a few months down the line, you will forget about the fear of being on camera. It's easier than you think. And remember, you are recording. You can always delete it. You can re-record as many times as you want. Okay? Equipment. You're gonna need some equipment. As a basic to start with, you need a camera. You need some kind of ring light and a microphone as well. Okay? Just to start with. Then you can grow and expand from there, but camera, some kind of light, and microphone would be a good start. It's not going to be expensive. You can start with a phone camera as well. It's going to take time to build audience, okay? It's not going to start. It took me about 6 months to build the initial audience for my courses. And it's probably going, depending on the time hours you put in as well, in collaborating with people, in chatting, in commenting, in posting, etc., etc. So probably it can take quicker than that. You just need to put in time and hours, and you need to be willing to build a team, because at some point, like I said, you need to focus on being on camera, recording content, rather than, you know, doing the social media, etc. Okay, so the way you deal with this is you find people and outsource the tasks on people per hour, Upwork, etc. Time to build audience, you need to be consistent again, one thing focus. So we focus on one thing at a time, basically. Okay, and that's how you do this. Again, I have plans to release the online course, the step-by-step formula in the WealthX project. If that is something you would be interested in, and if there is enough interest, I will do an early release. Other than that, it will come definitely, because I want to have all these systems in the WealthX project. So that is it, guys. Those are your 5 ways of making money online. Some of them are passive, some of them are less passive. So we discussed the referral or affiliate marketing, which can be a passive way, and it's that easy to start. It costs you zero money to start. You can start it even tomorrow by signing up for our affiliate program. We've got the links in the chat. And you know, if you have 200 friends, I'm sure somebody will be interested in self-improvement and attending some of my trainings. Okay, and you can start building up your commission. Other than that, just use ClickBank, find the offer that works for you, and then start marketing that offer. So that's your affiliate marketing. You are absolutely amazing way of making money online. Then we've got the Amazon FBA, my cash machine of choice. There is some potential to be passive income if you use virtual assistants and outsource some of these tasks, or if you take part in our new Amazon Concierge program. But generally speaking, if not, then you need to be in that business, analyzing reports, dealing with suppliers, etc. But nonetheless, it's got a great earning potential, and it's fun. It's a lot of fun to have actually your own branded products. Then we've got the digital marketing agency, which is an awesome business model as well, with amazing potential and instant earnings. But again, you need to be a little bit on the technical side, and you need to be willing to talk to people. If you are kind of, you know, outgoing, open-minded, you enjoy talking to people and want instant earnings, that might be a great idea for you as well. So that's that. Then we've got the book or booklet or something like that, which again doesn't take a lot of money. If you have an idea you always wanted to share it with the world, okay? It's not difficult to do this in today's world, and you can use social media to promote and build audience around your niche, category or idea, okay? And then we've got the online courses, which is not passive. The book, by the way, is a passive business model, passive online income. The online courses are definitely not passive, nonetheless provide a great opportunity for growth, for fulfillment, for sharing, for connection with people, and also great potential earnings if you do it right, okay? But you do need to invest a little bit more time and a little bit more money to start with in order to set up, in order to create at least initial part of your course, and to kind of assemble the audience around your niche or category, okay? So let's wrap up this training. Like I said, you've got the links in the chat. Pre-order the book if you want to. It's going to be absolutely amazing, I promise you. And I'm super, super excited. I've got the full brief. It's going to be in steps. It's going to be step-by-step guide. It's just going to be amazing. I'm super excited about this. Then we've got the life plan, okay? That's going to be strategic, personalized plan for 2022, plus the three strategy sessions, live sessions with me on camera. We can create your personalized strategy, then I will follow up with you, make sure you are achieving your goals and you are following up the plan we set together. This is going to be personalized to your budget, your circumstances, what to do now, what to do next, what are the gaps in your mindset, what to work on, where to go, what kind of goals, etc., etc., okay? And also make sure to join our Facebook group, okay, which you have the link as well somewhere, I don't know, oh, in the comments, in the chat. Make sure, because we have a lot of free trainings, okay? And also we've got the WealthX project, which is £83 per month for the value that is inside of the course. That is a steal, okay? That price is nothing, trust me. Do a 1 month, do 2 months if you want to, do a trial. I'll give you a trial actually if you want to, for a month or so. You will see it's going to be worth it, okay? I promise you. So have a look, visit that page. You've got the link in the chat as well. And other than that, I'll see you in the next training. If you have any questions, let me know. I didn't see a lot of comments coming in. I know I kept you for an hour and a half, but again, there was like tons of things to cover today. So I hope that's been valuable. Thank you, okay, thank you guys so much. Pleasure speaking to you again today. Make sure to stay tuned in a Facebook group for the next free training. There is one more I want to do before Christmas, just to kind of give you a head start into 2022. So I will make an announcement. But other than that, thank you so much, and I'll speak to you soon. Thanks. Bye-bye. Mm-hmm.